Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the world of Wayne. We now got part 22, which is basically stages 73 to 76 of the IXO Collection's release and build the Peugeot 205 1.9 GTI. So far, this is what the vehicle's looking like at the moment. We haven't actually put the top on yet. That's just me wanting to see what it looks like. So I'm going to take that off for today's episode because we're going to be fitting the bonnet. We're going to be putting some more windows in as well. So loads to do on this. But I'll just keep this safely over here and let you know that if you want to get this for yourself, I've put the link down here to the IXO Collections website. You can get this all the way from issue one. Over there as well, you'll see the build, the other build I'm doing. I'll put a link up there for that, which is the Porsche 917KH. But without further ado, let's get cracking. So we're going to be starting today's build by doing the hinges for the bonnet. Now these hinges are metal, just so you know. Everything you see me doing here is metal, so I'm going to identify what hinge we've got here. So this one's got L, so that's the left hinge, which means this one over here is the right hinge. We also need two brackets here, which are going to be going onto these inside sections of that hinge. And then we need these two smaller brackets, which are bent, making sure that the longer end is facing towards this hinge. I'm just checking that now. So that means that this is going to be going on this way, just like the pictures there. Whoops, can't keep that the right way up. There we go, that way. And the same on this one over here. Now they're going to be held into the hinges with AM screws. We are going into metal, so once again, I'm going to be dropping this in some oil. And I still get people do asking me, what oil am I using? I'm just using a regular 3-in-1 oil. Now, this is the oil that I found. I didn't actually sort this out. I didn't think this is the oil that you definitely need to use. But Mrs. Welder Wayne was using it on her sewing machine, and I thought, that's good stuff. So that's why I'm using it. So here's the first screw. Just for that smaller end, you don't want them doing too tight because obviously you want these to still be able to move. So I am going to put them tight so that there is a little bit of resistance on it. Like that. It should still be able to hold its own weight there. And then I'll put the second one in here. Just like that. Once again, that's going to be held in with an AM screw. That one's in as well. And once again, I just want to make sure it's not too tight, but they can both still be moved. So that looks like that. Now, must remember that the larger section on this bent one here, if you can see, is nearest to the hinge. And the shorter one is here, and it actually goes in this direction around it. So I'm going to repeat that for this one here. And there we go. We've got two hinges completed. Now, once again, on the next section, these are the parts that are going to be going on to the bonnet. We've got an R and we have got an L. So we're just going to match up what we've got here. So the R will be going onto this one here. And basically the way this is going to go is we've got a smaller hole and a bigger lug here. These are just going to be going on top just like that. Once again, they're going to be held in with AM screws. That's one in. I haven't tightened that up at all really at the moment. I just want to make sure that these are both in because this is going to get a little bit fiddly trying to line these up, as you can see. Here's the second one. I'm happy with that. And now I'll tighten them up again. Not too tight. You want them to be able to move, but not too loose that they're falling to pieces in your hand. You've got to find that happy sweet spot. And there you go. I think that's the happy sweet spot there. You see it's holding its own weight there. It's not walking around, but it is able to move. We're going to again repeat that on the other hinge. And there we go. That's the second one in. And once again, as you can see, that moves okay as well. Now I'm just going to put these to one side and bring over my part work upgrades mat, which looks like this because I need the bonnet now. Here's the bonnet. And that's what that's looking like. This is going to be the left side. This is going to be the right side. So when I'm attaching these in, the right one is going to go in here, just like that. And then the left one, in a similar fashion, will be going into the other way, like that. Now these are going to be held in with BM screws. And these ones you really do want to make sure are in really tight. That's one. And here's the second one. Now the only other thing we've got is in this little area you can see here, just show you closer, we're going to be putting a bonnet support bracket. That looks just like this. The flat side of this is going to go towards the center of the bonnet, so it's going to go in just like that, and it's held in with an AM screw. Again, got that here, make that nice and tight. Excellent. We're then going to be putting this on the vehicle, so I'll bring over the bodywork here, and I'm just going to be lining the lugs up on here to the holes that we've got down this section. So I'll keep it upright while I put this in. There we go. And then these are going to be secured in from the other side here with CM screws. We've got two on this side, two on the other side. Now this bonnet is going to fall out while I just prepare the rest. I've just noticed that my wing mirror has fallen out again. I will get that back in afterwards. So I'll put one screw in one side. I'm just going to do the same on the other side so I know that that's fully in. Which means I've only got two more to put in each side. So let's turn that over, see what that looks like. I'm looking at the lines here to make sure that they're fully in there. Open it up, see how that's supported. There's no wobble in there, that looks good. That's perfect. And that on the side camera is all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 74, we're going to be working on the rear quarter light glass. And we've also got some trim panels here. I will keep the mat up here actually, because we're going to be putting the trim panels in first. Now they are labeled again. This one says R for right. This is the right hand side of the vehicle. So this is just going to be going on the back section just here. And it fits in, as you can see, let's turn this around. It fits in just like that. Now it's going to be held in by two CM screws. Now those screws are actually in the side of the car just here. So one at the top. Because pretty much we're working with metal now, just assume that every screw that I'm putting in now, I have put in oil. Because in the video editing, it does look like sometimes I forgot. But trust me, I haven't forgot. There we go, that's one side done. And then all we're going to do, turn it over, get the other trim panel, put that into place. Whoops, that way round. And once again, two CM screws. I've actually got my voice come back today. So that's good. I was going to take your advice with whiskey, honey, lemon. But you would have had me completely and utterly paralytic if I tried all the almonds that I was suggested yesterday. But there you go, that's the second one in as well. So now we're going to be putting in the quarter light windows here. And all I'm going to do is turn it on its side again. And then they're just going into this place. They have got lugs at the bottom. So you just line them up. Make sure you're putting the right one in. Which I've just realized I wasn't there because the lugs wasn't lining up, but they are now. And then just push the lugs in. But when you do this, just push the external parts of the glass here. Don't push the middle because you don't want to crack it. But there we go. That's in place perfectly. I will clean that off afterwards just with get my fingerprints off that. And we just do the same on the other side. Line it up. Wham. Two. Three and four. Excellent. So we'll just get me soft towel just to clean my fingerprints off. And this side, I do need to clean the windscreen again, to be honest with you, but I could spend all day cleaning this. But there you go. That is all there is to do in that stage. Then 75, we've got some trim panels again, some mouldings, and we've also got the fuel filler cap. So again, these should be quite a quick stage because these are just pop-in things. And as you can see on the end here, we have got the indents for where these are going to go. Now do, before you put them in, there is a left and a right. So I'm going to put the short one in first. And this is labeled with an L at the bottom. Make sure they're round the right way. So this one's going in here, because I'm doing the left-hand side of the car first. Not quite sure what side the instructions want me to do, but there we go. Make sure that's pushed all the way down so it's flush in there. Take the other left one there. This one's just saying GTI. And again, push that nice and hard in there like that. And we do exactly the same on the other side, although it's a lot easier this time because we know where each one goes. So we've got the GTI, smaller than the last one, because on this side we've got the filler cap. And then we've got the 1.9. So now that's looking like that. Keep that to one side just for a second, because I've just got to set up the fuel cap. And basically we've got the lock cap and the filler base that we're going to be putting together. There is two lugs to help line this up, but this is just going to be going in like this. And you want to push it together till you hear that click, so that will keep itself in there like that. We're then going to put this where you just saw before. It's going to be going into this section here next to the trim. It has got a locating lug, so when we put it in, it will fit in nice and flat like that, held in from the other side with an AP screw. And funny enough, I don't really have to turn the vehicle over for this, because I can get to that screw hole just through the rear window, which isn't in the vehicle yet, as you can see. And that will hold the filler cap in place. Excellent. But with that trim panel and the filler cap, that's all there is to do in that stage. So the last stage, which is stage 76, we have got the rear hatchback door, or the tailgate door, of the vehicle. Looks just like this. Wow, big. Now in that pack you do get a tiny bit of plastic which is loose, so don't lose that. This is the nozzle for the washer that goes on the back. So I'm just going to keep that to one side, because the first thing I'm going to do is put in the hinges. Now it's hinged from the top here, so once again we need to make sure we got the left and the right one sorted out. This one's stamped with an R, so this will be the right hand side one. This is the left hand side of the vehicle. So this is going to be going on here, like that, which means the other one, the left one, will be going over here. Now they're going to be held in with AM screws. So one here, remember, going into metal again. Anytime you see a hinge, you really do want to make sure that they're on tight, because you really don't want any wobble when you're opening and closing doors. So again, bit of oil, this one in like this. I think we're having a car week this week, because we did the Eleanor yesterday. Today we're doing the Peugeot. I believe tomorrow I'm doing the Dodge Charger, the next stages of Dodge Charger. So I am enjoying that, which means Thursday I might challenge myself to get back to the Ferrari F40, which I've got eight of still to do. But there we go, that's the hinges in place. Now the washer nozzle here just gets pushed into this hole here. Just see it. And there you go, that's in like that. You know what, that was one of the trickiest parts of the whole build, just getting that all the way in. Perfect. We don't actually get to fit this to the vehicle though. That's the end of the stage. But you know me, I can't just leave it there. I want to know what this looks like. So I'm going to bring the vehicle over and I'm going to put this where it goes. It's going to be held in kind of like this. Get it into the channels up there. Matter of fact, let's turn it upside down to get this in. And there we go. That's that in place. As you can see, opens and closes. It's not even in at the moment, but I've got it opening and closing. So I think I'm going to try and put this back on the vehicle so I can keep it all together in one piece. It's not too hard to get the vehicle back together. It's actually one of the easier ones to do. But looking pretty good, isn't it? Let's show you. Look at that. Look at that. I'm holding a Peugeot 205 in my hands. Absolutely crazy. But we are getting there until the next stage. And my wing mirror's in there this time. I can't remember if it was in there last time. I love this build. I love the detail on this build. And if you want to get this for yourself, once again, put the link down here to the IXO Collections website. You can get this all the way from pack one. Remember, I did a live stream last Tuesday, so there's going to be no live stream tonight. I'm actually off to watch Venom with Mrs. Wilder Wayne today and having a sneaky Nando's afterwards. But I'll be back tomorrow and there will be a Patreon stream tomorrow night. I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.